perfect disciple. Experiencing grace when you can't get your act together. So when is it that we don't get our act together?
Usually.
That's pretty much a constant, so you know. This is real. This, in other words, this is real grace. This isn't phony, fake grace or religiosity or stuff like that. This is a nice quote by Jed. In the middle of this series, we're going to be doing this for a while. Church's teaching discipleship seems divine, designed for people who don't appear to really need it. That's a thought, isn't it? How about discipleship? The cut-ups and the screw-ups and the tire and the turnip and the worry and the worry. How about putting the cookies on the bottom shelf? Isn't that what Jesus did? Jesus, the light of the world, born in a dirty state. What places do you think to have a baby? Born in a dirty state. On the very first day, God got messy. He wants to come down into our messes. That's our God. Getting in sync with the rhythms of grace. With Jesus speaking in Matthew, are you tired, worn out, burned out on religion? Let's say these questions right here. Are you tired? Are you worn out? Are you burned out on religion? All trying to find this open sesame, all the rights and wrongs, and do this, don't do this. This is the right way, this is the wrong way, this is it. Jesus says, what's his answer? Come to me. As we say here, it's all about religion. I understand that more in my head than in my heart. It's all about relationships. It's about a relationship with God and having your own relationship. This is life. It's about relationships. Well, the question is, how do you have good relationships, right? We can't really, we can only give away what we know. Isn't that right? We can only reproduce what we have. So we go to God, who is the perfect Father. Your neighbor said, you grew up in a dysfunctional family. You grew up in a dysfunctional family, and guess what? That's what we learn, and that's how we understand relationships, and we pass on our dysfunctions, right? Because that's all we know. We can't pass on what we don't know. We're familiar with that. And when push comes to shove under pressure, what do many of us do? Regress. We go back to our old patterns. That's just the way we do. Jesus says, come to me, get away with me, and you'll recover your life. I'm going to show you about relationship. Jesus wants us to be in his family. His family's not dysfunctional. Hallelujah. He's got a functional family. Father, Son, Holy Spirit. They get along so well that they say they're one. And he wants us to be one too. He knows the secrets. We just need to get in with him. And how does he treat me? You've been patient with me over the years. There's a lot. Let's extend patience to one another. What's been given to us, we need to extend to each other, right? I'll show you how to take a real rest. Walk me with me and work with me. Watch how I do it. How I do life. Learn the unforced rhythms of grace. I like it. Learn the unforced rhythms of grace. There's a rhythm to real relationships. And it's wrapped up in grace. It's wrapped up in grace. Unforced. I like that. I won't lay anything heavy or ill-fitting on you. Keep company with me, and you'll learn to live freely and lightly. How's that sound?
Awesome.
Sounds pretty good, doesn't it? Turn to your neighbor and say, it's time to get over yourself.
Time to get over yourself.
I need that. How many need that? We need to get over it. We need to get over ourselves. Isn't that a big deal? That's a big deal. We need to get over ourselves and beyond ourselves. That's a big deal. If that just sounds like weirdness to you, ask God for revelation for that. That is a big deal. How do we actually reach to each other if we can't get beyond ourselves with one person? How do we reach to God and open up to Him and really seek Him if we can't get over ourselves and beyond ourselves? How do we really minister to our kids and our family if we can't get over ourselves and beyond ourselves? Wait, let's think about it. Jesus says, if you start putting me first, you'll get beyond yourself and over yourself. And yet, finally, the day we breathe our last breath is when we'll finally get over ourselves. I understand that. This is a process. Right? So what is grace? We talk about the unforced rhythms of grace. What's grace? Let's get rid of a little grace. Let's talk about what grace is. It's not someone's name. I mean, it could be someone's name. What does that actually mean? What does grace mean?